Hello everybody, welcome to the Python math section. In this video, I'm going to show you the way to prove whether a certain number is a palindrome number. So what is a palindrome number? When you read the number from the left-hand side or from the right-hand side, you will get the same number. In this case, we call that number a palindrome number. So for example, when we have this number with 5 digits, when we read from the left-hand side, we will get the same answer as reading from the right-hand side. So in this case, this is the palindrome number. So for another number, which is this one, when we read from the left-hand side, we will get the same value as reading from the right-hand side. So in this case, it is also a palindrome number. So how can we prove that a certain number is a palindrome number? We can just pick up the digits from the right-hand side, and then we just put the digits picked up from the right-hand side, and then we just align those digits picked up along the left-hand side. And then we just check if the number obtained finally is the same as the initial number. So let us see an example. Suppose I want to check whether 151 is a palindrome. I can do something like this. First, we just handle the entire number. And then I want to get the rightmost digit of this number. So I just get the remainder of 151 divided by 10. And then I will get 1, which is the digit on the far right-hand side of the value of concern right now, which is 151. And then I can just remove the rightmost digit, so that 151 divided by 10 gives me a quotient of 15. So in this case, the digit 1 on the far right is removed. And then I just put the remainder to be aligned along the left-hand side. So I will have 1 first, shown here. Okay, then after I've removed the rightmost digits, I will only remain 15. So I'm going to handle 15. And then I just do the division by 10, and then I get the remainder, which is 5. And after getting the remainder, I can remove the rightmost digit, which is 5 in this case. How can I do so? I just do the division of 15 by 10, and then I just get the quotient, which is equal to 1. And then I just put the remainder along the left hand side. So I will just put 5 on the right hand side of the original value of 1. In this case, I have 1 and 5 joined together. And then after getting the quotient, which is equal to 1, I just handle 1 here. And when I do the division by 10, I will get the remainder of 1. In this case, I can just put 1 along the left hand side of the arrangement. And then after that, I can remove the rightmost digit, which is 1. So after dividing 1 by 10, the quotient is simply equal to 0. When the quotient is equal to 0, I will just stop the entire process. And in this case, we can check the digits. The digits are actually reversed. And after that, I can just get the final number after a series of operations. And we can see that this number have the digits reversed compared to the original number. Okay. And we can see that the evaluated number equals the example number. So in this case, even though the digits are reversed, I will simply get the same number. So in this case, we can see that a given number is actually a palindrome number. Now let us see the implementation. So I need to get the number first. I just allow the input from the user, and then I turn the number to an integer. And then I can try the algorithm shown on the slides. Because I need to remove the rightmost digits in each of the steps, I need to really save the number to a variable called given number, so that the original number can still remain in the program for the final step of the comparison process. Now I give a name of the generated number after each step of the algorithm. Initially, I set it to 0. We know that we have to do the removal of the rightmost digits in each of the steps. So we can stop the iteration if we know that the quotient is zero. So we have to ensure that the given number, which is obtained by removing the rightmost digit, will always be larger than zero in order to go through the algorithm. Okay, I just want to get the rightmost digit by doing the modulus evaluation, which is equal to finding out the quotient when we divide the given number by 10. Okay, and then I can go to the next step. Here, I just want to remove the rightmost digit after getting it from the modulus evaluation. Okay, and the next step is simply to pack up the digits along the left-hand side. How can I do that? I can simply evaluate the number after each step of the packing process. Okay, the generated number is simply equal to the product of it plus the digit, so that I'm able to generate each of the packed digits. So we will see the effect when I do the demonstration later. And after getting the generated number, I can simply compare it with the input number. If the generated number is equal to the number, it just tells me that the given number is simply a palindrome. Otherwise, I just say that it is not a palindrome. So let me run it. Oh, I have got an error. Oh, I got the space here, so I have to remove the space. So I put a number first, for example, 2, 3, 2. And in this case, I can say that the number is actually a palindrome, because when I read it from the left-hand side, it is equal to the result by reading it from the right-hand side. So how about another number like this one? Sorry, I didn't play the program. Okay, it is not a palindrome because when I read the number from the right-hand side, it is not equal to the result by reading it along the left-hand side. So in this case, I'm able to really see the effect of the palindrome number. So this line generated number equals generated number times 10 plus digit is helping me to generate the result after picking up a digit from the right hand side. So the first place is to have 5, and then the second place is to have 1, and then the third place is to have 7. So I just build up the generated number step by step. So this program is complete in order to help me show that whether a number is a palindrome or not. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.